Gatsby. In my younger and more vulnerable years, my father gave me some advice that I've been turning over in my mind ever since. Whenever you feel like criticizing anyone, he told me, just remember that not all the people in this world have had the advantages that you've had. He didn't say any more, but we've always been unusually communicative in a reserved way. And I understood that he meant a great deal more than that. Gatsby. The man who gives his name to this story represented everything for which I had an unaffected scorn. But if personality is an unbroken series of successful gestures, then there was something gorgeous about him. Some heightened sensitivity to the promises of life, and a romantic readiness such as I have never found in any other person, and which it is not likely I shall ever find again.
I'm paralyzed with happiness.
Hello, Daisy.
Nick Carraway, Miss Baker. Nick is my cousin.
Second cousin, once removed.
He and Tom graduated Yale together.
Oh, did you play football as well?
No, Tom was the football hero.
Nick! There you are!
Hello, Tom.
Care for a drink?
Not yet, a little early for me, thanks.
Who needs a refresher?
Nick, I've been telling Jordan all about you.
You find the place all right?
Hard to miss.
Where are you staying?
Across the Sound.
West Egg?
A little cottage I found.
Really?
What a strange community. On either side of me are these huge estates that must go for 12, 15,000 for the summer.
What are you paying?
80 a month.
Huh. Well, welcome to East Egg.
How long are you staying?
Till I make my fortune.
Tom will help you, won't you, darling?
I stopped off in Chicago on the way out. At least half a dozen people send their love.
Do they miss me?
Oh, the whole town's desolate. All the cars have their left rear wheel painted black as a mourning wreath. And there's a persistent wail all along the North Shore.
How gorgeous. Let's go back, Tom. Tomorrow. Ooh, you ought to see the baby.
Oh, I'd like to.
She's asleep. Haven't you ever seen her?
Never.
Well, you ought to.
What are you doing these days, Nick?
Learning to be a bond man.
Who with?
Probity Trust?
Never heard of them.
Oh, well, you will.
Any money in bonds?
Everyone I know is doing it, making lots of money. After being in the war, the Midwest felt sort of dull to me. That's why I've come east. Father's financed me for a year.
Where are you from?
St. Paul. Minnesota?
Uh-huh. You'll be rich as Midas one day.
I've bought about a dozen books on banking and credit and investment securities.
You'll help him, won't you, Tom?
Oh, I'm stiff. I feel like I've been lying on that sofa for as long as I can remember.
Oh, well, don't look at me. I've been trying to get you to New York all afternoon. Mm.
This'll help.
It is prohibition.
So what?
Besides, I'm absolutely in training.
How you ever get anything done is beyond me.
I recognize you from somewhere.
You said you live across the Sound in West Egg. I know somebody there.
No, I don't know a single person.
Oh, you must know Gatsby.
Gatsby? What Gatsby?
He owns that huge mansion. It looks like an imitation of a French hotel.
Oh, the one with the tower.
Throws huge parties.
I live right next door. Our lawn's practically...
In 2 weeks, it'll be the longest day in the year. Do you always watch for the longest day in the year and then miss it. I always watch for the longest day in the year and then miss it.
We ought to plan something.
All right, what do we plan? What do people plan? Look, I heard it. You did it, Tom. Mm-hmm. I know you didn't mean to do it, but you did do it. That's what I get for marrying a brute of a man. A great big hulking physical specimen of
I hate that word, hulking, even in kidding.
Hulking. Hulking, hulking, hulking.
Have a drink, Nick.
All right.
We've got a nice place here.
Enormous. The sunken garden.
Belong to the main, the oil man. I'll show you around.
Don't take him away yet.
Come on, I'll show you the ponies.
Please, Tom!
You planning to stay in the East?
I'd be a goddamn fool to go anywhere else.
This is a permanent move.
They hated France.
Oh, how long were you there?
About a year. And then we followed the polo circuit.
Drifting. Drifting endlessly. Parties and yachts and hulking men hitting wooden balls with mallets.
You make me feel uncivilized.
Oh, civilization's going to pieces. Gotten to be a terrible pessimist about things, Nick. Have you read The Rise of the Colored Empires by this man, Goddard?
Why, no.
Well, it's a fine book, and everybody ought to read it. The idea is if we don't watch out, the white race will be utterly submerged. It's all scientific stuff. It's been proved.
Tom's getting very profound. He reads deep books with long words in them. What was that word?
It's up to us who are the dominant race to watch out, or these other races will have control of things.
We've got to beat them down.
The idea is that we're Nordics. I am, you are, and you are. And we've produced all the things that go to make civilization. Science and art and all that. Do you see? Excuse me.
I love to see you in my house, Nikki. You remind me of a rose, an absolute rose. Doesn't he, Jordan? An absolute rose. Excuse me.
So what is it that you're in training? This man Gatsby you spoke
Quiet.
About.
Quiet. I want to hear what's happening.
Is something happening?
You mean you don't know? I thought everybody knew.
I don't.
Why? Tom's got some woman in New York.
Got some woman?
I mean, she might at least have the decency not to telephone him at home. I mean, see what I think is...
It couldn't be helped. I looked outdoors for a minute, and it's very romantic outdoors. There's a bird on the lawn that I think must be a nightingale. Yes, a nightingale come over on the Cunard or the White Star Line. He's singing away. It's romantic, isn't it, Tom?
Very romantic. Before you leave, I want to take you down to the stables.
Each other very well, do we, Nick? Even if we are cousins. You didn't come to my wedding.
Well, I wasn't back from the war.
Oh, yes. That's true. I'd forgotten. War took a lot of young men away. I've had a very bad time, Nick, and I'm pretty cynical about everything.
Suppose she eats and cries and everything?
Who?
Your daughter.
Pammy. Oh, yes, listen, Nick. Let me tell you what I said when she was born. Would you like to hear? It'll show you how I've gotten to feel about things. Well, Pammy was less than an hour old, and Tom was God knows where. I woke up out of the ether with an utterly abandoned feeling, and I asked the nurse right away if it was a boy or a girl. She told me it was a girl. So I turned my head away and wept. All right, I said, I'm glad it's a girl. And I hope she'll be a fool. That's the best thing a girl can be in this world. Beautiful little fool. You see, I think everything's terrible anyhow, and everybody thinks so. The most advanced people, and I know. I've been everywhere, and I've seen everything, and I've done everything. Sophisticated. God, I am so sophisticated.
10 o'clock. Time for this good girl to go to bed.
Jordan's playing in the tournament tomorrow over at Westchester.
Oh, you're Jordan Baker, the golfer.
Good night. Wake me at 8, won't you?
If you'll get up.
I will. Good night, Mr. Caraway. See you anon.
Of course you will. In fact, I think I'll arrange a marriage. Come over often, Nick, and I'll fling you two together. You know, lock you up accidentally in linen closets and push you out to sea in a boat and all that sort of thing.
Good night. I haven't heard a word.
I knew I'd seen her somewhere before. I see pictures of her in the paper all the time. Golf championships at Palm Beach, Asheville. Wasn't there a story about her?
She's a nice girl. They oughtn't to let her run around the country this way.
Who oughtn't to?
Her family.
Her family is one aunt about 1,000 years old. Besides, Nick is going to look after her, aren't you, Nick?
Rich girls don't marry poor boys.
Nonsense! She's going to spend lots of weekends out here this summer. I think the home influence will be very good for her.
Is she from New York?
From Louisville. Our white girlhood was passed together there. Our beautiful white...
Did you give Nick a little heart-to-heart talk while I was on the phone?
Did I? Well, I can't seem to remember, but I think we talked about the Nordic race. Didn't we, Nicky? Yes, I'm sure we did. It's just sort of crept up on us, and the first
thing
you know...
Don't believe everything you hear, Nick.
Haven't heard a word. Well, good night, Tom. Daisy.
Good night, my sweet one. My dear, sweet Nicky. Good night. Good night.
Yes. Gatsby turned out all right at the end. But it's what preyed on Gatsby, what foul dust floated in the wake of his dreams, that's been haunting me, and haunts me still.
I want you to meet my girl. Hello, Wilson. How's business?
Can't complain. When are you gonna sell me that car?
Next week. I got my guy working on it now.
Works kinda slow, don't he?
No, he doesn't. And if you feel that way about it, maybe I better sell it somewhere else after all.
I didn't mean that, Mr. Buchanan. I just meant...
Get some chairs, why don't you, so somebody could sit down.
Sure.
I try to teach him manners.
Myrtle, this is Nick Caraway. We went to Yale together.
How do you do?
Hello.
I want to see you.
So?
Get on the next train.
Well, what if I don't want to? Oh,
you want to.
Oh, what makes you so sure of that? You think you could come in here and just order somebody
just
around?
Get on the next train.
Will you get me that dog, you promise?
I'll get you a whole brew.
Oh, you promise?
Woof! Woof!
Well, in that case...
Meet me at the apartment in an hour.
All I meant about the
car was... Just showing Nick here the neighborhood.
Yes, sir, Mr. Buchanan. I was just thinking...
I said I'll see about the car.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Mr. Buchanan.
Terrible place, isn't it?
Where are we?
Queens. It's hard to imagine people choose to live like this.
Awful.
Was it good to get away?
Doesn't her husband object?
Wilson? He's so dumb, he doesn't even know he's alive. He thinks she goes into New York to see her sister. I'm tired of dancing. Nick, have a drink with me.
I really should get home and study.
There's plenty of time to make money. Come on, here. Drink up.
If Chester could only get you in that pose, Myrtle, I think it could make something of it. Couldn't you, Chester?
I'm in the artistic game.
Really?
You should see his work. Chester has photographed me 127 times. Haven't you, Chester?
129.
Come on, dance with me, Mr. Carraway.
I would love to change the light. I'd like to bring out the modeling of your features, that profile, and I try to get hold of all the back hair.
I wouldn't think a change in the light. I think it's just...
Shh! We need more to drink. Myrtle, stop shaking your ass and get us some more ice and mineral water before everybody goes to sleep.
I told that boy about the ice. These people, you have to keep on them all the time.
I've done some nice things out on Long Island. Two of them are framed downstairs.
Two what?
Two studies. One of them I call Montauk Point, the Gulls. The other I call Montauk Point, the Sea.
Where the hell is she?
Do you live down on Long Island, too?
I live at West End.
Really?
Would we know your place?
No, it's just a small summer rental.
We were down there at a party about a month ago.
At a man named Gatsby's.
Do you know him?
I live next door to him.
Really? Ooh. Well, they say he's a nephew or a cousin of Kaiser Wilhelm, or is it von Hindenburg? I'm scared of him. I'd hate to have him get anything on me.
Somebody told me that he killed a man once.
I don't think it's so much that. It's more that he was a German spy during the war. I heard it from a man at the party. Knew all about him. Grew up with him in Germany.
That's not right, because he was in the American army during the war. You look at him sometime when he thinks nobody's looking at him. I bet he killed a man.
They say he doesn't even live in that house.
but lives on a boat that floats secretly up and down the Long Island shore.
Chester! I think you could do something with him!
Ah, Tom! Stop it! You made me spill everything!
Neither of them can stand the person they're married to.
Can't they?
Can't stand them. And what I say is, why go on living with them if they can't stand them?
If I were them, I'd get a divorce and get married to each other right away.
Doesn't she like Wilson either?
You try being married to a stupid, ambitionless bastard who smells like grease.
You see?
As soon as they can, they're going out west.
It's really his wife that's keeping them apart? She's a Catholic, and they don't believe in divorce.
Hey, leave Daisy out of this.
Wait, Daisy's not Catholic.
She really ought to get away from her husband. They've been living over in that garage for 11 years, and Tom's the first sweetie she ever had.
It was on those two little seats facing each other, the ones that are always left empty on the train. I was going to New York to see my sister and spend the night. He had on a dress suit and patent leather shoes, and I couldn't keep my eyes off of him, but every time he looked at me, I had to pretend to be looking at the advertisement over his head.
What the hell are you doing?
What?
Get over here.
Shut up, I'm telling a story. So when we got into the station, he was right next to me, and his white shirt front pressed up against my arm. And so I told him I had to call the police, but he knew I lied. I was so excited when I got into the taxi cab with him, I didn't hardly know I wasn't getting into the subway train. All I kept thinking over and over was, you can't live forever. You can't live forever.
Hey, that's enough, Myrtle.
Oh, the great man speaks.
That's enough booze for one afternoon.
Get your hands off of me. And where's that dog you promised me? Mrs. McKee. Give you this dress as soon as I'm through with it. I've got to get another one tomorrow. In fact, I'm going to make a list of all the things I've got to get. A massage, and a wave, and one of those cute little ashtrays where you touch a spring, and a black silk bow for my mother's grave that'll last all summer, and that dog Tom promised me. I'm going to make a list of all the things so I don't forget what
I really should get going.
No, stay!
Yes, stay!
We live right downstairs. I could show you my portfolio.
I've been drunk just twice in my life. And the second time is this afternoon. And I don't think Daisy would find it admirable.
Daisy! Daisy, Daisy, Daisy! Everybody's got to talk about her like she's a goddamn saint!
Shut up, Myrtle!
Don't you tell me to shut up! I'll say whatever
I told you about using her name!
Daisy, Daisy, Daisy!
I mean it, Myrtle!
I'll say her name whatever I want to! Daisy, Daisy! You bastard! You son of a bitch bastard!
Oddly, I began to like New York. And all the while, there was music from my neighbor's house. In his blue gardens, men and girls came and went like moths among the whisperings and the champagne and the stars. And then, early one Saturday morning, a chauffeur crossed my lawn with a surprisingly formal note. The honor would be Gatsby's, it said, if I would attend his little party that night.
Your face is familiar. Weren't you in the 3rd Division during the war?
Yes. How did you? I was in the 9th Machine Gun Battalion.
I thought so. I was in the 7th until June 1918. Do you miss it?
War? Yes. I think I enjoyed it so much I came back restless. Made going home pretty dull.
I know what you mean. I doubt most of the people here have any idea what it's like to be in the trenches.
It's not something you forget.
No, it's not. So where are you from?
St. Minneapolis.
I know them well. Listen, I just bought one of those new hydroplanes and thought I'd try it out tomorrow. Do you want to go with me, old sport? Just by the shore along the Sound.
What time?
Well, any time that suits you best.
Yes, yes! By the way, I'm Nick. Nick
Caraway. Mr. Caraway.
Miss Baker, hello.
I thought you might be here. I remembered you lived next door. Having fun?
Well, it's been an unusual party for me. See, I live right next door, and this man Gatsby sent a chauffeur over this morning with an invitation, but I haven't seen the host all night.
I'm Gatsby.
What? I beg your pardon.
I thought you knew, old sport. I'm afraid I'm not a very good host, old sport.
Sorry to interrupt. You have a call from Detroit.
Tell him I'll call later.
That may not be such a good idea.
If you need anything, just ask for it, old sport. If you'll excuse me, I'll rejoin the both of you later. I said a small town, Maya. He's no good to us if Detroit is his idea of a small town.
I feel like an idiot. I kept imagining Gatsby as extravagant and fat, middle-aged. Who is he? Do you know?
He's just a man named Gatsby.
Where is he from? What does he do?
Oh, I haven't the faintest idea.
People don't just come out of nowhere and suddenly buy a palace on Long Island.
Well, Gatsby did.
He must have some sort of a past.
Now you're started on the subject.
It's just that everyone keeps talking about him.
Well, he told me once that he was an Oxford man. However, I don't believe it.
Why not?
I don't know. I just don't think he went there.
I've heard the wildest rumors about him.
Oh, that he killed someone?
Yes.
That he was a German spy.
Yes!
That he runs an underground pipeline from Canada.
He does?
Anyhow, he gives large parties, and I like large parties. They're so intimate. There isn't any privacy at small parties. Are you having a good time?
I'm having a good time with you.
Dance with me.
All right.
You know, Daisy's very taken with you. She hasn't stopped talking about flinging us together.
Well, then she'd be happy about tonight.
In love with her.
Isn't everyone?
Yes. If I tell you a secret, do you promise to do something about it?
What do you mean?
Tom's woman in New York? She isn't the first. I mean, one night in Santa Barbara, California, right after he and Daisy got married, Tom ran into a wagon on the Ventura Road and ripped a front wheel off his car. The woman he was with got into the papers too because her arm was broken. She was a chambermaid at the Santa Barbara Hotel.
Why does Daisy put up with it? Why doesn't she just leave him?
Maybe you're the one meant to help her.
I beg your pardon. Miss Baker?
Yes?
Mr. Gatsby would like to speak to you. Alone.
With me?
That's what he said.
Think about what I just told you. Oh, well. Please, come see me. Phone book under the name Mrs. Sigourney Howard, my aunt.
She is a very famous person.
Yes, I know.
And Mr. Gatsby's a fine fellow, isn't he? Handsome to look at, and a perfect gentleman.
Yes.
He's an Oxford man.
So I've heard.
He went to Oxford College in England. You know Oxford College?
I've heard of it, yes.
One of the most famous colleges in the world.
Listen, have you known Mr. Gatsby for a very long time?
Several years. I made the pleasure of his acquaintance just after the war. I knew I had discovered a man of fine breeding after I talked with him an hour. I said to myself, there's the kind of man you'd like to take home and introduce to your mother and sister. I see you're looking at my cuff buttons.
They look like ivory.
Finest specimens of human molars.
Oh, well, that is a very interesting idea.
Yeah, yeah, well, I'm going to run off from you two young men before I outstay my welcome.
There's no need to hurry, Maya.
You're being polite, but I belong to another generation. Enjoy. Discuss your sports and your ladies, and as for me, I won't impose myself on you any longer.
hope I didn't say anything to offend him. We were talking about his cuff buttons.
He's quite a character around New York, a denizen of Broadway.
Who is he, anyhow? An actor?
No.
A dentist?
Maya Wolfsheim. No, Old Sport, no, he's a gambler. He's a man who fixed the World Series back in 1919.
Fixed the World Series? How did he do that?
He saw the opportunity.
Well, why isn't he in jail?
They can't get him, Old Sport. He's a smart man. Smart men are hard to get. Now, remember, we're going up in the hydroplane tomorrow. 9 o'clock?
I am so sorry I didn't recognize you earlier.
Don't mention it, Old Sport. Don't give it another thought. 9 o'clock.
I'll be there.
Well, good night.
Good night.
And good night, Old Sport.
Daisy! Daisy! Daisy, where the hell are you? What are you doing down here?
Looking at the party lights.
I don't know how worried I get when you disappear like that.
Do you?
Of course I do. No idea.
We ought to go sometime. Dance again.
Associate yourself with those people? Come on, let's get inside.
I miss the parks.
I know you do. And we'll go again, I promise. But right now, Pammy needs you. Let's go.
I'll be up in a minute.
I said Pammy needs you.
And I said in a minute.
Fine. Fine. Do as you like.
You mean like you?
Look, I don't know what's gotten into you lately, but... forget it. Just come back before Pammy goes to bed.
It was so much nicer a long time ago when we had each other and the space about the world was warm.
What a machine!
Fantastic!
Thrilling, Old Sport!
Thrilling.
I thought we'd go to New York later and have lunch.
Anything, I'm all yours today.
Look here, Old Sport. What's your opinion of me?
What?
I said, what's your opinion of me?
Well, we've only just met.
Oh, be frank, Old Sport.
Honestly, I've heard all sorts of rumors.
I'm gonna tell you something about my life. See, I don't want you to get the wrong idea from all these stories that you hear. This is the God's honest truth. I'm the son of some wealthy people in the Middle West, all dead now. I was brought up in America, but I was educated at Oxford because I have a lot of ancestors who have been educated there for many years. You see, it's a family tradition.
In what part of the Middle West?
San Francisco.
I see.
My family all died and I came into a good deal of money. After that, I lived like a young Raja in all the capitals of Europe, Paris, Venice, Rome, collecting jewels, chiefly rubies, hunting big game, painting a little. Then came the war, Old Sport. It was a great relief, and I tried very desperately to die, but I seemed to bear an enchanted life. I accepted a commission when it began as first lieutenant in the Argonne Forest. You were there, right?
At St. Mihiel Salient.
This was near Sweely. I took two machine gun detachments so far forward that there was a half-mile gap on either side of us where the infantry couldn't advance. We stayed there for 2 days and two nights, 130 men with 16 Lewis guns, and when the infantry came up at last, they found the insignia of three German divisions among the piles of the dead. I was promoted to be a major, and every Allied government gave me a decoration. Even Montenegro. Little Montenegro down by the Adriatic Sea. This is the one from Montenegro. Do you see what it says?
Jerry D. Danilo, Montenegro, Nicholas Rex.
Turn it over.
Major J. Gatsby for Valor Extraordinary.
And here is another thing I always carry on me. A souvenir from Oxford days. This was taken in Trinity Quad. The man on the left is now the Earl of Doncaster.
Then it's all true.
Of course.
But I didn't mean it like that.
No, it's all right. It's all right, Old Sport.
Why are you telling me all this?
I'm gonna make a big request of you today, so I thought you ought to know something about me. See, I didn't want you to think that I was just some nobody.
So you planned all this?
No, I knew I could trust you. See, I always find myself among strangers because I drift here and there trying to forget the very sad thing that happened to me. You'll hear about it all this afternoon.
At lunch?
Yes, but not with me. You'll be having lunch with Miss Baker.
Do you mean to tell me you're in love with Miss Baker?
No, old sport, I'm not. But Miss Baker has kindly consented to speak with you about this matter.
I don't understand. Why don't you just tell me yourself?
It's a delicate matter, old sport. I would rather if we were able to...
Nick.
Tom, what are you doing here?
Been here all the time. Where the hell you been? Daisy's furious because you haven't called up.
Mr. Gatsby? Mr. Buchanan.
Sir? How'd you get this far uptown to eat, anyhow?
Well, I was having lunch with Mr. Gatsby and Miss Baker.
You behave yourself with her. I'll be up at the apartment later. Stop by and see us. We'll have a drink. You'll excuse me, I've got some friends waiting. It's nice to meet you, sir.
He's married to my cousin Daisy. Oh, they live across the sound from you.
Yes. look, I hope I haven't made you angry about this business with Miss Baker.
It isn't that, it's just... I don't like mysteries.
Thank you. It's nothing underhand. You don't make much money, do you, old sport?
Not very much, not yet.
No, I thought so. If you'll pardon my... I happen to carry on a little business on the side, a sort of sideline, you understand. And I thought that if you don't make
Hello,
very
boys.
Miss Baker!
Hello, Jordan.
Nick, Jay, did I interrupt something?
Oh, no, not at all, not at all. Please, sit down. Thank you, Miss Baker. Thank you both. Well, enjoy your lunch.
Is he always like this?
He knows what he wants.
It's nice to see you again, even under mysterious circumstances.
Not that mysterious. I mean, not really.
What's going on?
You know Daisy and I grew up together.
She told me.
Daisy Faye, the most popular girl in Louisville. We all envied her. She dressed all in white and had a little white roadster, and all day long the telephone rang in her house.
If you behave yourselves, I'll spare each of you exactly 1 hour.
And excited young officers from Camp Taylor demanded the privilege of monopolizing her nights. I'm walking by her house, this is 1917, and she is on the porch dancing with a lieutenant I'd never seen before. I mean, they were so engrossed in each other that they didn't see me, and he was looking at her in the way that every young girl wants to be looked at. And because it seemed so romantic to me, I've remembered that incident ever since. His name was Jay Gatsby.
Gatsby?
Lieutenant Gatsby.
And I didn't lay eyes on him again for over 4 years. I mean, even after I met him at one of his parties, I didn't realize it was the same person. Anyway, they became inseparable. Promises were made, and then he left for the war. She changed after that, became distraught, withdrawn. I mean, I don't know what happened, something to do with her family, but after the war was over, she just up and suddenly married Tom Buchanan of Chicago. And he arrived with an entourage in more pomp and circumstance than Louisville had ever seen before. The day before the wedding, he gave her a string of pearls valued at $350,000. I was a bridesmaid. Half an hour before the bridal dinner, I walked into her room and found her lying on the bed as lovely as the June night in her flower dress.
Congratulate me, Jordan.
And as drunk as a monkey. She had a bottle of champagne in one hand and a letter in the other.
I never had a drink before, but oh, how
enjoy.
I mean, I was scared. I could tell you, I had never seen a girl like that before.
Here, dear. Take these downstairs and give them back to whoever they belong to. Tell them all Daisy's changed her mind. Do you hear me? Say Daisy's changed her mind.
I mean, I didn't know what to do. I locked the door and got her into a cold bath.
The dearest heart of all. Do you hear me? The dearest heart of all.
She wouldn't let go of that letter. She took it into the tub with her and squeezed it into a little wet ball and only let me leave it in the soap dish when she saw that it was coming to pieces like snow. But she didn't say another word after that. I gave her spirits of ammonia, put ice on her forehead, hooked her back into her dress, and a half hour later, we walked out of that room, pearls around her neck, and the incident over.
What was in the letter?
It was from him.
Gatsby?
He was coming home from the war to marry her.
Then why did
she'd heard the name Gatsby for the first time in years the day that you first visited. Do you remember?
What a strange coincidence he's here.
But it isn't a coincidence at all, don't you see? Gatsby bought that house to be near Daisy, to be just across the bay from her.
Really?
He wants to know if you'll invite her over some afternoon and then let him come over.
So you mean to tell me he's waited 5 years, even bought a mansion, just so he could come over some afternoon to a stranger's cottage to have a liaison?
I mean, all this time he's half expected her to wander into one of his parties one night, but she never has. I mean, that's why he gives them. He wants her to see his house, to see what he's created for her. And you live right next door.
Incredible.
Will you do it?
Does she want to see him?
Oh, she's not to know about it. Gatsby doesn't want her to know. You're just supposed to invite her to tea. I mean, alone, of course.
I'm not sure I'm comfortable.
Well, Daisy ought to have something in her life, don't you think?
And what if I invited you to tea? Would you come?
Ask me.
You have everything you need in the shape of tea?
All set.
Are you sure you're all right with this? I mean, I wouldn't want to do anything that's out of the...
Fine. Would you like something while you wait?
No.
It's raining.
I noticed.
That's it, I'm going home.
What?
It's too late, nobody's coming to tea.
I
can't
wait. Don't be silly, it's just 2 minutes to 4.
No, you don't understand, old sport, I can't.
See?
This is absolutely where you live, my dearest one. Ah, it's adorable. It's absolutely adorable. Are you in love with me? Is that why I had to come alone? Jay.
Hello, Daisy.
I'm glad to see you again.
We've met before.
You haven't met for many years.
5 years. Next November.
Jordan says you've been naughty with her.
Have I?
See, I'm the perfect matchmaker. Though I'm very angry with her, she left my car out in the rain with the top down and it's ruined. It's absolutely ruined. At first she lied about it, so you be careful with her, Nikki. She is incurably dishonest.
Well, if you'll both excuse me.
Where are you going?
I thought I'd get some tea.
I'll help you.
What's the matter? This is a mistake. This is a terrible, terrible mistake.
Stop, you're just embarrassed, that's all. Daisy's embarrassed too. She is just as much as you are.
Does the suit look all right?
It's very nice.
But what'll I do? What'll I say?
Stop it, you're acting like a little boy.
And not only that, but you're rude. Daisy's in there all alone. Now go on.
I thought if we ever met again, it'd be when we were old and decrepit. You're as handsome as ever, Lieutenant Gatsby.
Would you like to sit?
Yes. Did you know I'd be here?
I arranged it. Here.
Are these all me?
The newspaper clippings from the last 5 years.
My debut. Chicago. Look at that silly hat. Oof. Even Europe.
He's quite a polo player.
Yes. Tom has a knack for winning. Jay, I tried to wait.
Look at this one.
How handsome you are in your uniform. You never married.
No.
I'm sorry for all the hurt I caused you when we could have been so happy. I've missed you, Jay. I've missed you so much. I've never missed you so much as I do now.
Oh. Hello, old sport.
It stopped raining.
Has it?
Would you look at that, Daisy? It stopped raining.
I'd like you and Daisy to come visit my house. I'd like to show her around.
You sure you want me to come?
Absolutely, old sport.
My house looks well, doesn't it?
That huge place there?
It took me 3 years to earn the money that bought that house.
I thought you inherited your money.
I did, old sport. Do you like it?
I love it, but I don't see how you live there all alone.
I keep it full of interesting people, night and day. People who do interesting things. Celebrated people. Music rooms and sunken baths, bedrooms in period style, marble swimming pools, and jonquils.
My favorite.
Oh, hundreds and thousands of jonquils everywhere.
Oh, Jay.
I even have a man in England who buys me clothes. He sends over a selection of things at the beginning of each season, spring and fall.
They're such beautiful shirts. It makes me sad because I've never seen such beautiful shirts before.
possible to reverse time? Erase it. Just erase it and begin again. Do you think that's possible, Jay? You said you'd come back from no matter where you were, and here you are, gleaming like silver. And I said I'd be waiting, remember? My hair was damp that night.
Yes.
And you were so handsome in your Brooks Brothers uniform, smelling like new goods. The garden smelling of wisteria and pine forest. And you told me you loved me, and I thought you were the sweetest person in the whole world. And the music, everywhere. Filling the pine forest crater with our future. We were golden happy, weren't we? Golden happy. And you trusted me with the dearest heart of all, and it's so much more than anybody else in all the world's ever had. Sent a green card. I'm giving out green tonight.
Are you having a good time?
We're together here in your garden, Jay. Your beautiful garden. Doesn't seem possible, does it? I can't believe it's possible. We have somebody look it up in the encyclopedia to see if it's really true. Look it up under G. G for Gatsby. But if you want to take down any more addresses, here's my little gold pen.
Who is this Gatsby anyhow?
They say he owns some drugstores. A lot of drugstores.
Yeah, right.
He built them up himself.
Probably some big bootlegger.
Be quiet. You've no reason for talking like that.
He certainly must have strained himself to put this menagerie together.
At least they accomplish things. They're more interesting than the people we see.
What's come over you? They're vulgar. Broadway riffraff. I don't know why I let you talk me into this. Come on, let's go. Uh-huh.
Don't leave me.
Yeah.
Hey, old sport.
Hey, I don't know who the hell you think you are. What's going on here, but I'm sure as hell gonna find out. Get in the car.
Jay, I...
You know, if it wasn't for the mist, we could see your house across the bay. You always have this green light that burns all night at the end of your dock.
It burns for you, Jay. It's always burned for you.
Jay!
Just a moment, Maya. Do you mean that? Do you really love me?
Yes.
Well, then that's all that matters. I'll take care of everything. Wait here, I'll be right back.
I'm gonna leave, Tom.
About time.
When?
When it can be arranged. In fact, I want to just go now and not tell Tom anything.
Are you sure?
I think I'm making a mistake.
Daisy! Daisy!
I wouldn't ask too much of her too soon. You can't repeat the past.
Can't repeat the past? Why, of course you can. And this time I'm going to fix everything. Just the way it was before.
Almost 5 years he'd waited for her. There must have been moments when Daisy tumbled short of his dreams. Not through her own fault, but because of the colossal vitality of his illusion. It had gone beyond her, beyond everything. How could one mortal possibly live up to it? The king's daughter, the golden girl, illusion. But no amount of fire or freshness can challenge what a man will store up in his ghostly heart.
Expecting us for lunch. Gatsby's coming too.
Is he all right? I went over to his house the other day and this character right out of a Cops and Robbers picture opens up the door and says, "What do you want?" Is Mr. Gatsby home, I asked. Nope, he says, and slams the door in my face.
Oh, he's fired all the servants.
Why?
So there won't be any gossip? Those are Wolfshine's relatives up there taking care of the place. I mean, Daisy sees him almost every day in the afternoons.
That isn't very discreet.
So?
She ought to be more careful, is all.
You really are moral, aren't you?
It isn't that. It's just, what if Tom finds out?
Well, Daisy drove over to Gatsby's yesterday with her suitcases packed, ready to run off, but he wouldn't go.
So he's got her, but now he doesn't want her?
No, of course he wants her. They love each other, but it has to be done right. I mean, he's looking for some sort of atonement, a renunciation of the years lost.
But how can Daisy possibly do that?
He wants her to tell Tom that she's never loved him. She's promised to do it today. Come on, we don't want to miss the fun. I'll get the car.
I'll drive.
Why?
You're a rotten driver.
I am not.
You nearly killed that workman the other night.
What workman?
The one you hit with your fender. Either you ought to be more careful, you oughtn't to drive at all.
I am careful.
No, you're not.
Well, then other people are.
What's that got to do with it?
They'll keep out of my way. It takes two to make an accident.
And suppose you met somebody as careless as yourself.
Well, I hope I don't. I hate careless people. That's why I like you.
Oh.
Mr. Thomas Buchanan, the athlete.
Rumor has it he's on the telephone to his girl.
Mr. Gatsby. I'm glad to see you again, sir. Nick. Jordan.
Make us a cold drink, please. You know I love you.
You forget there's a lady present.
Oh, well, you kiss Nick too.
What a low, vulgar girl.
I don't care anymore. Go on, kiss him. I want to see you kiss him.
When are you going to tell him?
Soon, I promise. Darling, don't look so sad. There's nothing in all the world I want but you and your precious love. Come here, quick. Look at that. I'd like to get one of those pink clouds and put you in it and push you around. Thank heaven, something cool to drink. Well, what do we do with ourselves this afternoon? And the day after that? In the next 30 years?
Don't be morbid. Life starts all over again when it gets crisp in the fall.
But it's so hot, and everything's so confused. Let's all go to town. Who wants to go to town? You look so cool. Always so cool. You resemble the advertisement, you know? The advertisement of the man in the shirt.
All right. Let's go to town. Come on. What's the matter, anyhow? If we're gonna go, let's get started.
We're just gonna go like this?
You wanted to go.
It's too hot to fuss. Come on, Jordan.
I don't see the idea of going to town. Women get these notions in their heads.
Shall we take anything to drink?
I'll get some whiskey.
I can't say anything in his house, old sport. She's got an indiscreet voice. It's like it's full of...
Her voice is full of money.
Yes, that's it. Her voice is full of money.
We'll go to the plaza.
Yes, and hire 5 bathrooms and take cold baths and drink mint juleps.
Shall we take my car?
I would have expected a chauffeur.
I prefer to do my own driving.
Are the gears standard?
Yes.
Well, then how about you take my coupe then, and let me drive your car to town?
Take some getting used to.
I'm sure I can manage.
We may need to stop for some gasoline.
Well, if it runs out, I can stop at a drugstore. You get anything at a drugstore nowadays. Come on, Daisy. Let's take Mr. Gatsby's circus wagon.
You take Nick and Jordan. We'll follow you in the coupe.
Did you see that?
See what?
You think I'm pretty dumb, don't you? Well, perhaps I am, but I have a... almost a second sight sometimes that tells me what to do. I made a little investigation into this fella.
And you found he was an Oxford man?
Oxford man. He wears a pink suit.
He did go to Oxford.
Oxford, New Mexico, maybe. Stopping for gas. Wilson, let's have some gas. What do you think we stopped for? To admire the view?
I'm sick. I've been sick all day.
What's the matter?
I'm all run down.
Well, do I have to do it myself?
I need money pretty bad, Mr. Buchanan. I was wondering what you're gonna do with your old car.
How do you like this one?
nice yellow one.
Pretty fancy, eh? Ever seen anything this fancy before?
No, sir, Mr. Buchanan.
You like to buy it?
Big chance. No, but I could make some money on the other.
What do you want money for all of a sudden?
We've been here too long. Got to get away. Myrtle and I want to go west.
She does?
She's been talking about it for 10 years. I'm gonna get her away.
Why is that woman staring at me?
What do I owe you?
I just got wised up to something funny the last 2 days. Yeah, wised up real good. That's why I want to get away. That's why I'm bothering you about that car.
What do I owe you?
I really need that car, Mr. Buchanan. Kid.
What do I owe you?
$1.20.
Keep the change.
I don't mean to keep bothering.
I'll let you have that car.
You will?
Yeah. Send it over tomorrow afternoon.
Crabbing about it, for Christ's sake.
Why not let her alone, old sport? You're the one that wanted to go to town.
It's a great expression of yours, isn't it?
What is?
All this old sport business. Where'd you pick that up?
Now, see here, Tom. If you're going to make personal remarks, I won't stay here a minute. Make us some mint juleps.
By the way, Mr. Gatsby, I understand you're an Oxford man.
Not exactly.
Oh, yes, I understand you went to Oxford.
Yes, I went there.
When was this?
I said I went there.
And I heard you, but I'd like to know when.
It was in 1919. I only stayed 5 months. That's why I can't really call myself an Oxford man.
Yeah, right.
It was after the armistice. It was an opportunity they gave to some of the officers. We could go to any of the universities in England or France. I chose Oxford.
Open the whiskey, Tom, and I'll make you a mint julep. Then you won't sound so stupid to yourself. Oh, look at the mint.
Wait a minute. I have one more question for Mr. Gatsby.
Go on.
What kind of a row are you trying to cause in my house?
He isn't causing a row. You're causing a row. Please have a little self-control.
Self-control? I suppose the latest thing is to sit back and let Mr. Nobody from nowhere make love to your wife. Well, if that's the idea, you can count me out. Nowadays, people begin by sneering at family life and family institutions, and next they'll throw everything overboard and have intermarriage between blacks and whites.
Good God, Tom.
We're all white here.
I know I'm not very popular here. I don't throw big parties and invite every riffraff from Broadway in the picture shows. I suppose you have to make your house into a pigsty in order to have any friends.
We can talk about my house later when there are no ladies present. What I want to tell you, old sport...
Please don't. Please. Let's all go home. Why don't we all go home?
That's a good idea. Come on, Tom. Nobody wants a drink.
I want to know what Mr. Gatsby has to tell me.
Your wife doesn't love you, all right? She never loved you. She loves me.
You must be crazy.
She never loved you. Do you hear? She only married you because she was tired of waiting for me. It was a terrible mistake. But in her heart, she never loved anybody except me.
Look, why don't we all just head back?
We're not going anywhere.
Yes, we are, Tom. Come on, Daisy.
It's about time somebody finally told you exactly what
you... Are you going to lecture me on character, Jordan? Ha! That's a laugh. Hey, Nick, has your girlfriend here told you about the tournament at Asheville that she cheated to win that tournament? Oh, great golf champion. Now, what was it you wanted to tell me, Jordan?
Let's go, Daisy.
Sit down, Daisy.
Stop yelling at her.
I want to know what's been going on.
I told you what's been going on. Going on 5 years and you didn't know.
You've been seeing this fellow for 5 years?
Well, no, not seeing. No, we couldn't meet, but we both loved each other the entire time.
Oh, you must be crazy. I can't speak about what happened 5 years ago because I didn't know Daisy then. And I'll be damned if you got within a mile of her, unless you brought the groceries to the back door. But everything else is a goddamn lie.
No.
Daisy loved me when she married me, and she loves me now. She does, though. The trouble is that sometimes she gets these foolish ideas in her head, and she doesn't know what she's doing. And what's more, I love Daisy, too. Sure, I go on a spree every once in a while, and I make a fool of myself, but I always come back. Don't I, Daisy? And in my heart, I love you all the time.
You're revolting. Do you know why we left Chicago? I'm surprised they didn't treat the story that little spree of his. And Santa Barbara. And the Riviera.
Daisy, that's over now. That's over. None of that matters. Just tell him the truth. All right, that you never loved him and it's all wiped out forever.
Well, how could I love him? Possibly.
You never loved him.
I never loved him.
Not at Deauville?
No.
Not that time I carried you from the punch bowl to keep your shoes dry. Daisy.
Please don't. There, Jay. You want too much. I love you now. Isn't that enough? I can't help what's past. I did love him once, but I loved you too.
You loved me too?
Even that's a lie. She didn't even know you were alive. Why, there are things between Daisy and me that you'll never know. Things that neither of us can ever forget.
I want to speak to Daisy alone. She's all excited now.
Even alone, I can't say I never loved Tom. It wouldn't be true.
Of course it wouldn't.
As if it mattered to you.
Well, of course it matters. Listen, I'm going to take better care of you from now on.
No, you don't understand, old sport. You're not going to be taking care of her ever again.
I'm not? Why is that?
Because Daisy's leaving you.
Oh, nonsense!
I am, though!
No, she's not leaving me! Certainly not for a common swindler who'd have to steal the ring he put on her finger.
I won't stand this. Please, let's go home. It's so hot.
I'll take care of
you. Who are you, anyhow? You're one of that bunch that hangs around that Meyer Wolfsheim. That much I happen to know.
Let's go, Daisy. Let's go.
I made a little investigation into your affairs, Mr. Gatsby.
Yeah, well, you can suit yourself about that, old sport.
Found out what your drugstores were.
Yeah, what about them?
He and this Wolfsheim bought a lot of side street drugstores here and in Chicago and sold grain alcohol over the counter. That's just one of his little stunts. I picked you for a bootlegger the first time I saw you. And I wasn't far wrong.
It's prohibition! Nobody cares! And where do you get your booze from, old sport?
Hey, don't call me old sport! This drugstore business, it's just small change. You got something going on now that everybody's afraid to tell me about. Something with this Meyer Wolfsheim? But I'll find out about it. Oh yeah, I'll find out about it, old sport! You bet your ass on that!
No,
please.
No.
Shut up!
I can't
stand
this anymore!
Are you gonna kill me, old sport? My car keys, please. If you'll excuse me.
Want any of this stuff? Jordan. Nick.
No.
hell's the matter with you?
I just realized today's my birthday. I'm 30. I'm 30 years old. I was 30, and before me stretched the menacing road of a new decade. It was 7 p.m. and we finally got into the car and started to Long Island. Tom talked incessantly, laughing and exulting as if he'd won a football match. And beside me, her head on my shoulder, Jordan nestled close. But I didn't know her anymore. 30. The promise of a decade of loneliness. A thinning list of single men to know. A thinning briefcase of enthusiasm. Thinning hair. So we drove on. Toward death. Through the cooling twilight.
You may fool me, but you can't fool God.
What are you doing, George?
His wife's man. That's what they say. Think I don't hear that? His wife's man. No more, Myrtle. No more.
George, what are you doing with my clothes?
We're leaving. Day after tomorrow. Soon as I sell that car.
You're crazy.
I found this dog leash yesterday. Hidden in the bureau.
You got no right.
Think I'm stupid, Myrtle?
It's for my sister, for her dog.
Think I'm stupid because all I own is a garage?
No, George.
I got things figured out, Myrtle. I ain't stupid.
I never said you.
Coming back home with your face all busted up.
It ain't right what you're doing.
Something's not right, that's for sure.
Give me back my clothes. You got no right. Oh, I hate you. I hated every minute with you. What are you going to do, George? Beat me, huh? You're going to beat me, George?
I'm sorry, Myrtle. I didn't mean it.
Shut up! I can't stand your voice. It's like a slug crawling in the dirt. I should have left you a long time ago.
Please, Myrtle, don't leave me. I'm getting the money, just like I promised. I'm getting the money.
He's come back for me. Oh, my God, he's come back. Wait!
Myrtle!
Wait!
M-I-C-A.
No, H. M-I-C-H-A.
What's going on?
H-A.
Listen to me.
Hey, what do you want, fella?
What happened? That's what I want to know.
Auto hit her.
Instantly killed.
What?
She ran out on the road.
Instantly killed.
Son of a bitch didn't even stop his car.
There was two cars. One coming, one going, see?
Going where?
Which direction?
Hold on a minute here.
One going each way. Well, she ran out there waving her arms crazy-like, shouting at him, beat me, throw me down and beat me, but I'm going. And the one from New York knocked right into her. Must have been going 30 or 40 miles an hour.
What's your relation to them?
I own the diner up the road. It was a yellow car, a big yellow car.
You don't have to tell me what kind of car it was. I know what kind of car it was.
You've got to pull yourself together. Listen, I just got here a minute ago from New York. Are you listening to me? Wilson, listen. I was bringing back that blue car that we were talking about, remember? That yellow car that I was driving this afternoon. It wasn't mine. Do you hear? It wasn't mine. I haven't seen it all afternoon. It belongs to somebody else. I borrowed it. What's going on over there? I'm a friend of his. He says he knows the car that did it. It was a yellow car. And what color is your car? It's a blue car. A coupe.
He's telling the truth. We've just come from New York. We were on our way to West Egg, and we saw something had happened, so we stopped.
All right. Let's clear this area. Now, if you'll let me have that name again, correctly this time. The goddamn coward. They didn't even stop his car.
Daisy! Daisy, wait.
Let me go, please. I need to get inside.
No, it's all right. Everything's going to be all right.
Don't you see?
Everything's gonna be fine, I promise you.
It's everything is so confused.
Daisy, this is all my fault. All right? And none of this would have happened if I'd handled things right the first time. But now I'm taking care of things.
I just wanted it to be beautiful.
Do you believe that I love you? Daisy, look at me. Do you believe that I love you?
Yes.
What was said at the hotel, it doesn't mean anything. All right, Tom was pressuring you. He was making you say things you didn't mean. He was upsetting you.
I'm no good for you.
No, you are the finest, loveliest, tenderest, most beautiful person I have ever met.
But what if...
Nothing's going to happen. Now, I want you to go inside. I'm going to wait here just in case he tries anything. If he does, I want you to turn the light off and on.
He won't hurt me.
I don't trust him. I'm gonna wait here just in case.
How long will you wait?
All night if necessary, my whole life if you want.
Do you really love me that much?
Yes.
But what do I say? I can't hide things. You know how I am, I'll ruin everything.
He knows you're upset. It's okay to be upset, but don't let him talk you into anything. All right, don't say anything. Just give me time to set things up and then we'll go away like we planned.
Yes. Yes, that's all I want. That's all I've ever wanted.
As soon as I know you're safe here tonight, I'll wait for your call. And then we'll go away to Louisville and we'll get married and we'll start over and we'll have the life that we were meant to have.
You asked me if it was possible to erase the past. The answer is yes. I'm erasing it right now, right here. All right, the past is erased forever and now it's only you and me.
Oh, my God. He's home. Jay?
Nothing's going to happen to you. I'll take care of everything. It's going to be all right. Nobody's ever going to hurt you again. Call me tomorrow. I'll wait for your call.
I ought to have dropped you in West Egg, Nick. There's nothing we can do tonight. I'll telephone for a taxi to take you home, and while you're waiting, you and Jordan go in the kitchen and have them get you some supper, if you want any. Come in.
No, thanks. I'd be glad if you called me the taxi, though. I'll wait outside.
Daisy's home. Goodbye then, Nick. Come by tomorrow.
Are you sure you won't come in, Nick?
No, thanks.
It's only 9:30. You may as well make the best of it.
Is it true?
What?
What Tom said, the scandal about your tournament.
What's that got to do with anything?
They say you moved your ball from a bad lie, that's how you won.
People say all sorts of things when you're famous.
I read about it. The caddy retracted his statement. Did you buy him off?
Nick, you're one of the few honest people I know. That's why I like you. Come on in.
Goodbye, Jordan.
Goodbye. Like that, you're throwing me over.
I need to go home.
You're throwing me over for a rumor.
I just need some time to think.
Fine. Be a coward. Run away. I don't give a damn about you anyway. I mean, hey, at least it was a new experience. Do you remember that conversation we had earlier about driving a car?
What about it?
You said that a bad driver was only safe until she met another bad driver. Well, I guess I met another bad driver, didn't I? I mean, it was careless of me to make such a wrong guess. I thought you were different, Nick. I thought you were a rather honest, straightforward person. I thought it was your secret pride.
I'm 30, Jordan. 30. I'm 5 years too old to lie to myself and call it honor.
Goodbye, Nick.
Hello, Nick. Jesus, what are you doing? Just standing here, old sport. Did you see any trouble on the road?
Yes.
Was she killed?
Yes.
I thought so. I told Daisy I thought so. It's better the shock should come all at once. She stood it pretty well. I got to West Egg by a side road and I left the car in my garage. I don't think anybody saw us, but of course I can't be sure. Who was the woman?
Her name was Wilson. Her husband owns the garage.
What the hell happened? Like, I grabbed the wheel from Daisy.
Daisy was driving.
Yes. But of course I'll say I was.
I just assumed...
You see, when she left New York, she was very nervous and she thought it would steady her to drive. And this woman rushed out at us as we were passing a car coming the other way. It all happened in a minute, but it seemed as though she was trying to speak to us, thought that she was somebody that we knew. Well, at first Daisy turned away from the woman towards the other car, but then she lost her nerve and she turned back. As soon as my hand grabbed the wheel, I felt the shock. God, I must have killed her instantly.
You ripped her open, for Christ's sake!
I don't want to
Why
know.
Why didn't you stop? Get some help!
I tried, but Daisy stepped on it, so I pulled on the emergency brake, and she fell over into my lap and asked to be taken home.
You've got to go to the police.
Can't do that,
Tell
old
them
sport.
It was an accident!
Now, I'm going to fix everything.
But everyone saw the car. There are eyewitnesses. You can't hide a car like that. They'll trace it back to you, and then they'll find out Daisy was driving.
I'm not going to let that happen. All right, and neither are you. She'll be all right tomorrow. I'm just going to wait here to see if he tries to bother her.
That's my taxi. You'd better come home with me.
I want to wait here until Daisy goes to bed.
Gatsby!
Good night, old sport.
I don't understand you people.
You should drink a cup of coffee, George. Come on, it'll do you good.
I have a way of finding out about that car, the yellow one. Who it belongs to? A couple of months ago, she came back from the city, her face bruised, her nose swollen. My God, you killed her.
Who did?
I have a way of finding out.
This has been a strain to you and you don't know what you're saying.
He murdered her.
It was an accident, George.
I'm one of these trusting fellas. I don't think no harm to nobody, but when I gets to know a thing, I know it. It was the man in that car. She ran out to speak to him and he wouldn't stop.
How could she have been like that?
She's a deep one.
Maybe you got a friend that I could telephone or...
I spoke to her. I told her, you might fool me, but you couldn't fool God. I took her to the window and I said, God knows what you're doing. Everything you're doing. You might fool me, but you can't fool God. God sees everything.
Nothing happened. I waited, and about 4 o'clock, she came to the window. She stood there for a moment, and then turned out the light.
You've got to get away. Atlantic City for a week, or up to Montreal.
I can't do that, old sport. I couldn't possibly leave Daisy.
Why won't you listen to me?
I owe you an apology, Nick.
I don't care about that.
I owe you an apology for some of the lies.
James Gats. That's really, or at least legally, my name. We're cousins, Nick. You and I. Two boys out of the Midwest who've come east to make their fortunes. My parents were farm people up in North Dakota, good people, honest, but poor. So I invented the sort of Jay Gatsby that a 17-year-old boy would be likely to invent. And I ran away to make my fortune. And then I met Daisy. You know, of course I expected her to throw me over. After all, what did I have to offer him? And some poor farm boy. But she didn't, because she was in love with me. is in love with me. And now I have her again. And this time it's going to be the way that it should have been.
Thank you. For what? 12 minutes to my train. I've missed 3 already. I really don't want to go to work today. I'll call you up.
You want to know something funny? I haven't used this pool all summer.
I really wish you'd leave town for a few days.
I know. You've been a good friend, Nick.
I'll call you about noon.
You know, Daisy should call soon, don't you think?
I suppose so.
I mean, after all, we made promises to each other.
Yes.
Well, goodbye. Hey, goodbye, old sport.
They're a rotten crowd, Gatsby. You're worth the whole damn bunch put together. I remember the rest of that day, and that night, and the next day, only as an endless drill of police, and photographers, and newspapermen. Most of the reports about Gatsby were a nightmare. Grotesque, circumstantial, eager, and untrue. I found myself on Gatsby's side, and alone. No one else cared. No one. Where were the party people now? I called up Daisy to see how she was taking it, but she and Tom had gone away that afternoon, leaving no return address. I wanted to get somebody for him to show him that somebody cared. I went into the room where he lay to reassure him. I'll get somebody for you, Gatsby. Don't you worry. Just trust me, and I'll get somebody for you.
I can't do it. I can't get mixed up in it.
But you were his closest friend.
I raised him up out of nothing, right out of the gutter.
The funeral's this afternoon.
I'd like to come.
Then come.
I can't. When a man gets killed, I never like to get mixed up in it in any way. I keep out.
He'd want you there.
Mr. Carraway, let us learn to show our friendship for a man when he was alive, and not after he is dead.
The day of the funeral, nobody came. Daisy never even sent a message, not even a flower. One afternoon, late in October, I saw Tom and Daisy walking ahead of me on Fifth Avenue. Just as I slowed down to avoid overtaking them, he suddenly saw me.
Nick!
Daisy, look, it's Nick.
What's the matter? You object to shaking hands with me?
Yes, you know what I think of you.
You're crazy, Nick.
Crazy as hell. I don't know what's the matter with you.
What did you say to Wilson?
I told him the truth. He came to the house while we were getting ready to leave. He was crazy enough to kill me if I hadn't told him who owned the car. He had his hand on a revolver in his pocket the whole time. What if I did tell him? Gatsby had it coming. He ran over Myrtle like you'd run over a dog. Never even stopped his car.
You're always my favorite cousin, Nick.
You're careless people. You smash up things and creatures and retreat back into your money. Or your vast carelessness, or whatever it is that keeps you together. And then you let other people clean up the mess that you've made. I couldn't forgive any of them. After Gatsby's death, the East became haunted for me, distorted. It was time to go back home, back west, where the blue smoke of brittle leaves stirs in the air, and the wind blows the laundry stiff on the line. As I brooded on all of this, I thought of Gatsby's wonder when he first picked out the green light at the end of Daisy's dock. He had come such a long way to this blue lawn and this huge failure of a house, and his dream must have seemed so close that he could hardly fail to grasp it. Gatsby believed in the green light, the orgastic future that year by year recedes before us. It eluded us then, but that's no matter. Tomorrow, we will run faster, stretch our arms out a little farther, and one fine morning, so we beat on. Boats against the current, borne back ceaselessly into the past.